Hey there, how goes the livings? Good, I hope. If it's not, have a cheesecake, it'll help. I'm recording outside today because it's absolutely beautiful. Deal with it. Anyway, in this tutorial, I'll be teaching you a couple of tricks to get you started in Photoshop. Today we'll be learning how to change the appearance of water droplets on a leaf by applying a color overlay.
Okay, so first off, open up Photoshop by clicking on the Photoshop icon. You can't just go clicking on any old icon, unless you want to open up Steam or something, because you know, maybe you want to play video games instead, and Papers, Please is pretty fun. Alright, time to get started. In the description, I've left a link to the image we'll be manipulating, so go pay it a visit, right-click, and hit Copy. Now, back in Photoshop, go up to File and select New to open up a new document. See, things are already looking pretty familiar from other programs you've used, like Microsoft Word or Paint. Not so bad. So as you can see, the dimensions for our canvas are actually already set to fit the image we copied from the link. Pretty cool, huh? Now, Photoshop has a default set to 72 pixels per inch, but I prefer kicking it up to 300. It's standard and gives us more to work with.
Like about 228 more pixels per square inch. Makes it less fuzzy. We don't need no fuzz. What do you think we're adding in? James P. Sullivan?
Alright, now that we have our canvas, paste the image you copied from the link by holding the button combination of Control and V. If you're using a Mac, that's Command and V. This is the quick key for paste, and it's also handy to know that the quick key for copy is Control or Command C. Quick keys are easy to learn and speed up the editing process significantly. Now, at this point, we have our image and can start manipulating it to make these water droplets different colors. First of all, we're going to want to copy this layer in case anything goes wrong. We can do this simply by dragging our layer down under the sticky note icon below the layers. Clicking on this icon on its own will simply create a new layer, but we don't need to do that quite yet. Now shut off the original layer by clicking the eyeball next to it. By doing this, the layer has become invisible and we can't edit it until we turn it back on. Now we're going to want to rename these layers by right-clicking or command-clicking if you're on a Mac, and selecting the Rename option. It's easy as that.
It's good to name your layers, by the way. It's good to get into that habit. Complex Photoshop projects sometimes have hundreds of layers, and if you don't name them, you're going to get lost very quickly.
Name your original layer Original and the new duplicated one Gray Copy. Now click on the gray copy layer, and on your keyboard, type the button combination Control or Command U. As you can see, it brought up a small window that allows us to manipulate the picture's hue, saturation, and lightness and darkness. Drag the saturation arrow all the way to the left to drain the picture of its color. Confirm the change you've made by hitting OK at the bottom of the window. Now, click the sticky note icon at the bottom of the layers to create a new blank layer. Just name that new layer after your favorite color. So now that we're all organized and have our three layers, original, gray copy, and your color layer, go over to the toolbar on the left and click on the black colored box. This will open up a window where you can select your favorite color. By dragging the bar to the right, up or down, you're able to change the color that you're selecting. And by dragging the dot around on the palette, you can find a shade of the color that you like the most or want to use. So now that we have our favorite color selected, go up to the toolbar and hit the magic wand tool. This tool allows you to make a selection by clicking on certain areas and it'll automatically grab similar shades around it. So click on the gray copy layer and using the magic wand tool, click on one of the water droplets. As you can see, it didn't grab the entire drop, but rather just chunks of it. This is because this tool works best on solid colors and is really good for removing unwanted backgrounds. You can change the sensitivity up at the top to make it more powerful or weak, but for now we're just going to switch tools and make it a bit easier for us. Click on the tool right next to it called the Quick Selection tool to finish up the selection we have selected. On the top tab though, quick click the second option that allows us to make more than one selection at a time. Now click on the water droplet until it's fully selected. Now the edge of the selection might look a bit janky, but that can be fixed by clicking on the option at the top labeled Refine Edge. Play around with the contract and expand and smoothness settings in this window for a bit until it looks smoother. As for the feather option, increase it to 2. Feathering makes your selection fade at the edges and make things look less chunky when you make a selection. You don't always want a feather, but for this, we do. Now with the selection you made, click on your color layer, and then in the toolbar, select the Paint Bucket tool. Now fill your selection by clicking within the boundaries. Now you have a color, but now we need to make it look more like the water droplet's color. Unless you like how it looks now, I mean, that's fine and all. Yeah, that looks great. Good job. Anyway, if you aren't satisfied with the blob of color, there is a small panel above your layers menu that currently reads Normal. If you click on it, a bunch of different options will come up, and the one that we want is called Overlay. As you can see, this layer style did exactly what it was supposed to. It overlaid it on top of the layer directly beneath it. Now we can be done from here, but if you want to make some improvements to your drop of water, select your blob of color with the magic wand tool on the color layer. Now select the gray copy layer, and at the top bar, click on Enhance, which is 3 over from File. When you click it, it'll open up a window of options, and we want to select Adjust Lighting. And then if we carefully cruise on over to the left, we'll have more options. Now we want to select Brightness and Contrast. Now we can putz with our brightness and contrast values until we find one that looks right with our droplet. I found that I like -3 brightness and +32 contrast. Now we're done! If you want to play around a bit, select the color layer and click on Command or Control U again to open up the menu we're playing with before, but this time drag the hue bar around to change the droplet's color. Now you can admire your awesome new wallpaper, make some other water droplets different colors, show off a bit, and even apply the skills that you've learned in other projects. You'll find that you can make a lot of cool projects simply by changing the colors of certain things. Here's some examples of stuff that I made while playing in Photoshop. Now I hope you enjoyed this video. I enjoyed making it a lot. I absolutely love Photoshop, and I know how to use the program to do a bunch of different things, but I am by no means a professional. I love teaching others how to use it, I love making videos, and I hope you guys want to see more of these because, well, I'm making more of these. I hope I could entertain you today, and I hope that you learned something new. Enjoy the rest of your waking hours, whether it be day or night, and I'll see you next time, and until then, keep breathing.